Diabetes mellitus is more frequent in current times from sedentary lifestyle and poor habits. Diabetes can also lead to peripheral neuropathy in some patients. Tingling, numbness in feet, decrease in grip strength are a few of the characteristic symptoms. Physiotherapists state that certain kinds of exercises can help alleviate the symptoms caused by peripheral neuropathy. Let us now watch the exercises. Diabetes can sometimes lead to peripheral neuropathy. Let us learn the signs and symptoms in peripheral neuropathy. Peripheral neuropathy is caused in peripheral nerves. Nerves in the peripheral parts of the body, such as hands, feet, legs, shoulders, forearms, and arms. The blood vessels to the peripheral nerves are affected from diabetes mellitus. This leads to damage of the nerves. The damage of the nerves leads to neuropathy. The common symptoms found in peripheral neuropathy are tingling in feet, burning sensation in feet, numbness, and weakness in muscles. We also see problems with balance in these patients. I will now explain the physical therapy care and a few exercises that could improve the symptoms caused from peripheral neuropathy. Before treating neuropathy, a diagnosis has to be made. When you consult a physiotherapist, the physiotherapist will check your sensation, vibration sense, and predict the possibility of having peripheral neuropathy. If the physiotherapist suspects that you may have peripheral neuropathy, they refer you to a doctor. A doctor will further evaluate you and perform confirmatory tests like nerve conduction study tests, which confirm the presence of peripheral neuropathy. When the diagnosis of neuropathy is confirmed, certain exercises and precautions could be advised. The suggestions, exercises, and tips described here are not meant to replace physiotherapy services. Performing these exercises under the supervision of a physiotherapist will help you perform the exercise with accurate technique and learn the exercises effectively. I will now demonstrate an exercise for foot mobility. The equipment needed for this exercise is a sensory foam roller. This is called a foam roller. Place it under your foot. Place the foot closer to the chair. Bearing weight on the foam roller, slowly roll your foot forward. By pushing down on the foam roller, the perception of sensation on the sole of your foot improves. Make sure the tips of toes are completely stretched. Allow yourself to feel the pressure on the tips of toes. Repeat this exercise 10 times. While you are performing this exercise, if the severity of peripheral neuropathy is worse, you will feel some discomfort at the start. However, you'll find some relief as you practice this exercise frequently. Now, relax. Repeat this exercise on the opposite foot. Allow yourself to feel the pressure. Make sure the toes are stretched. Repeat 10 times. Last time. This is the last repetition. Now, please relax. Let us move on to the next exercise. Take a towel and place it on the floor under your feet. With your toes, pull the towel in by curling your toes. Slowly relax and let go. As you can notice, the toes are being worked. The toe muscles get stronger with this exercise. Now push the towel out. Demonstrating the next set of exercise. This exercise is meant to strengthen the muscles in the sole of your foot. From the inner surface of foot, with the big toe, push the towel out from the inner side. Lift the foot up and bring it in. Now push the towel out again. Repeat it again. Push the towel outward. Good. Now repeat it 10 times. After you completed this exercise, with the little toe, push the towel in. Good. Exercise the other foot similarly. By performing this exercise, you'll feel the muscles in the foot working and getting stronger. Good. Now use the little toe and outer border of your foot to push the towel in. This is the second exercise. Now let me demonstrate you another exercise. This exercise strengthens the muscles in the shoulder blade and stretches the muscles in the chest, also called pectoral muscles. At times, you can see the diabetic patients walk leaning forward. As they walk bent over, they stumble on their feet and can fall forward. To avoid falling forward, strengthening the postural muscles will help them stand tall. To perform this exercise, start with holding an elastic band in both hands. Lift the arms to shoulder height and pull the band out. After pulling it out, bring the band back to the original position. Hold it for 3 seconds in the stretched position and bring it forward. Repeat 10 times. Now, relax. By addressing postural strength and correcting it in patients with diabetes, anterior falls can be limited. Let us now take a short break and we'll watch some more exercises that help relieve the symptoms. Let us now watch the exercises performed in standing position. With the exercises performed in standing, let us first view calf stretch. We are using an inclined stretch board for the calf stretch. Place the inclined board next to a counter or a sturdy surface. Stand on the inclined board. Stand with your hips forward. By standing tall, you will feel a stretch in your calf muscles. In some patients, the heel of the foot lifts while performing this exercise. If the heel lifts, correct the position of the patient and make sure the heel rests flat on the stretch board. After After 30 seconds, ask the patient to step back. Please step down. Perform this exercise 3 times. Demonstrating the next exercise for strengthening. This is called a heel raise. By raising the heel, you will strengthen the calf muscles. Stand with your hand supported on a kitchen counter or any sturdy surface. Now, shifting the weight forward, lift both heels. Hold it for 5 seconds. And slowly lower down. Repeat it 10 times. You can see the calf muscles tighten up. Moving on to the next exercise. This is called a single leg heel raise. Stand on one leg. Lift the heel up. Hold it for 5 seconds and slowly lower down. Now, stand on the right foot. Lift the heel up and lower. Do not bend forward as you perform this exercise. You can now see the calf muscles work even harder. Slowly lower your foot down, demonstrating the next exercise to address balance. To perform this exercise, face a kitchen counter. Shift the weight forward and back. As you are shifting the weight forward, the heels must not raise up. Likewise, shift the weight back. As you are shifting the weight back, make sure to not lift the toes up. Please shift your weight forward and back. Let the entire movement come only from the ankle. Do not lead from the trunk. Yes, that's it. Let a caregiver stand next to you for safety. Now, please relax. This completes the exercises in standing. The exercises that we worked on are foot mobility exercises, calf strengthening exercises, calf stretching exercises. We can also work on balance exercises with some equipment. Stand on a rocker board and turn the head right to left. Also, close your eyes and turn the head right to left. You can also practice the exercise standing on a pillow. These exercises may help improve your balance. Patients suffer with balance dysfunction from peripheral neuropathy. By performing these exercises regularly, you'll be able to improve balance that is affected from diabetic peripheral neuropathy. Hi viewers, you now watch the exercises, stretches that could help when the peripheral nerves are affected. If you're also suffering from peripheral neuropathy, perform these exercises with suggestion from a physiotherapist and avoid further worsening of the problem. Watch this show on ETV Mobile Win app anywhere and everywhere. If you would like to watch Arogya Mastu online, type youtube.com/ETV Life India or facebook.com/ETV Life India.